coming. I think the last piece you just heard is just a gem, and most people agree with that. The next work we're going to do is more of a problem. It's been called the most neglected major composition written by a major composer. And it's a shame. It is somewhat neglected. It has all the qualities that people expect from Schubert, going from happy to sad very quickly, and gloom and joy, and there's this presence of a kind of rambler, wanderer who goes off and happy, full of joy, and wandering around, and then becomes lonesome, homesick, becomes chillingly despairing. And so everything is there in the Schubert, but I think the problem is the piece is so long. Schumann was sure that he meant it to be a symphony, and Brahms was too, and they arranged for Joachim to make an orchestral arrangement of it. But there's no evidence that Schubert ever meant it to be anything than it is. And Katherine and I just love playing it. We can't stop. And I hope that you all enjoy it. It is in the arrangement we're playing. We're not playing any of the repeats. It'll be 35 minutes long. But I don't think there's any need for a penny to lock the doors. I'm sure you're going to enjoy it. And I even hope that some of you will come away thinking that it is the most wonderful and neglected major composition written by a major composer. So you'll hear it now.
Thank you. Of course, falls in love with the ballerina, and although they're traditional Russian straw puppets and not supposed to have any human attributes, they're full of emotion and passion, of course. And unfortunately, the ballerina spurns Petrushka and falls in love with the Moor. So Petrushka, in a jealous rage, goes after the Moor, and the Moor, of course, is much stronger and slays him with one slice of his scimitar. But Petrushka has his revenge. He comes back as a ghost and haunts them all, especially his nemesis, the charlatan. We're going to play three selections from the ballet. We're starting with the introduction, which is a sort of festival in St. Petersburg in the square, and you can hear bands going by, and the ballerina is dancing. And also, there's a repeated sort of very irritating little chord that's supposed to be the charlatan that keeps coming back. The second piece is waltz danced by the ballerina, which is very graceful, obviously. You'll hear how delicate and beautiful she sounds. And the Moor, who's sort of galumphing in the background awkwardly and out of step. And the last selection is Russian dance. And this is supposed to be in the ballet, all three puppets dancing furiously under the spell of the charlatan. We hope you like that.
Thank you. coming. We're, in the interest of some people celebrating the holiday and having their meal first, we'll end with no encore. We'll have them back next year. We'll see you all, maybe, we hope, next Sunday. Give us a call and let us know if you can come. Many, many thanks to you.